Go.
All right, so we're gonna go through a hip mobility series right here real quick. Start off with your hips angled to the side. Gonna try to keep your hands up the entire set. Step one, roll the hips over to the side, bridge up, swing the hip, stretching the hip flexor, rock back, stretch the hamstring, back forward on the hip, step up to a squat, elbows push the knees out. Inside leg, steps back, roll all the way back over, and then repeat to the other side. So flip the hips, bridge up, swing the leg, lean in, stretching the hip flexor, rock back, stretching the hamstring, back forward on the hip, step up, elbows press the knees out, chest is up, inside leg steps back, bring back down to the start. Rocking ankle mobility. So you're holding on to something here for balance. Could be a door frame, wall out in front of you. And what I'm gonna do, again, glue the heel to the ground. I'm gonna rock forward and then bring it back. Rock to the side and bring it back. Rock to the inside and bring it back. I can do another one on my back leg where now I'm emphasizing this back leg, knees bent and driving down forward, trying to keep that heel there glued to the ground. The other thing I can do on this exercise is take it into an overhead squat. So I go from the same position, all right, but now my arms are up overhead. So as I sit back and squat down, my arms can't fall forward, the wall's in the way. So I sit back as low as I can, pause it, and then drive back up to the top in that overhead squat. Reverse plank. This plank variation is gonna focus more on the glutes and post chain. So I'm gonna start with my legs straight, and I'll put my hands on my fist, so I'm in a neutral grip position. From this position, I'm gonna bridge up, squeeze, and lock out the glutes. Hold for the prescribed time of the rep. Now, from this to progressive, I can work that same plank hold and work in a march. So now every time I come up, I'm holding that plank single leg, trying to keep the hips up and the glutes activated. Bounce into a drop squat. So on this, I'm gonna start in a bounce again. Here, pull my toes up, and then I'm gonna drop down into a squat and right back up into the bounce. These are pogo jumps. Again, toes up in the jumps, drop down and back into the bounce. Low to high pogo jump. So I'm gonna start this exercise in my traditional low pogo jumps, pulling the toes up in the air. So I'm here in a bounce. Then, in this position, I'm gonna switch to a high jump, come up, and stick the landing. I'm back into the low pogo bounce, and then I'm gonna switch in high, and stick the landing. It's important that when I transition into that higher jump, I hit the ground as fast as I can, get up as high as I can, and stick the landing with good balance at the bottom. Weighted squat jump. Same idea here, I'm working a traditional squat jump, but I'm adding some weight. 15-pound dumbbells, you can also use jugs, backpack, anything you can to find some extra resistance. Weights are at my side, I'm in a good squat position, squat down, jump up, load in one rep, right into the next. High pogo jumps, so I'm gonna hit these jumps back to back, jumping as high as I can, pulling my toes up in the air. The jump is coming from the ankle every time. So I'm starting swinging my arms, I'm jumping up, and then quick touches from the ankle, exaggerate, pulling the toes up off the ground. Kneeling jump start, I'm going from this kneeling position, I'm jumping up onto 2 feet, I'm gonna hit a vertical jump and stick it, and then drive out and burst straight ahead. So from here, I'm swinging the arms and the hips, drive, jump up and stick, vertical, stick, burst.
Seated single leg vertical jump. Starting with my arms up top here. Coming back down. Resetting for the second rep. Coming back down. All right, single arm backpack swings. Same concept as the double arm backpack swing. We're just using one arm at a time now. Remember, the movement comes through my hips on this exercise. Going here, load the hips up. Through the hips.
contrast Bulgarian split squat with jumps. So we're gonna start off with our first few reps weighted in this exercise. So I'm gonna go one weight, opposite arm, opposite leg. So I got my leg pinned back right here, got my weight down here at the side. I'm gonna start off regular Bulgarian split squat, nice and controlled, drive up with a little bit of power. I'm gonna finish my reps, ditch the weight off to the side, and now I'm hitting Bulgarian split squat jumps to finish my set. Nordic hamstring curl. I'm gonna find something safe to wedge my feet underneath to hold down my feet and ankles. Could also have a partner hold your feet down as well. I'm gonna lean forward, keep my hips forward, and really try to fight and control it on the way down. Light touch and squeeze it back up to the top. Again, squeeze the glutes, lean into it, fight it. Quick touch and pull yourself back up. Slider lateral lunge. There's two different ways that you can do this exercise. We're gonna show an alternate version for today that's gonna cause a little bit more emphasis on the groin on my anchor leg. So I'm set up here in my lateral lunge, but I'm gonna shift my weight over with the slider. Then as I come back up, I'm pushing but also pulling with the groin back to the top. Again, I shift my weight over, slide into the side, and use that groin to help pull and squeeze back up to the top position. Band X walk lateral. I'm standing on top of the band. I have it under tension and set on my feet. I'm twisting the band up into an X, pull it up here by the chest, drop down into a half squat position, and step to the side. Bring it back, step to the other side. Over and back is one rep. Complete it for the prescribed number of reps. Single leg pogo jump, supersetted with single leg calf raise. So I'm starting off with my pogo jumps here up on the balls of the feet. Jump up, quick touches off the ground, trying to pull my toe up so I stay on the balls of the feet. I finish my jumps, I'm going same leg, right over to the side, balance up, right into single leg calf raise. Band lateral ankle strength. Pay attention closely to how I'm setting this up. So I have my band in a circle, my foot is right here in the middle of the circle. I'm gonna take the back edge of the circle and flip it into an X. Now I have the band tied around the ankle joint. From there, I can wrap the band around the foot, and now I have it pulled to the outside. I'm gonna roll the ankle in and bring it back out. Roll it in and bring it back out. High rep count, good control reps, get as much range of motion as you can. When you finish on that side, you're gonna unloop the band around, tie it to the other side. So now it's pulling my ankle in, and I'm gonna rotate out, and then let the band pull me back. Rotate out, let it pull me back. Again, working to maximize the range of motion that I have, push into the band as hard as you can with that ankle joint. Band core rotation. I'm gonna set myself up here with the band looped onto my foot, and I'm putting my foot out wide to create tension to rotate the band to the side. From here, I'm starting off, press the arms out in front, rotate, and bring it back to tension. Rotate, bring it back under tension. It's important that I always keep the band under tension for the full length of the exercise, and I'm turning my shoulders to stretch through the core. Band in good morning. I'm gonna stand on top of the band, so I got both feet on here to anchor it down, and then I'm raising the band up over my head, and I'm getting it pinned back on my traps. So it's not pulling down on my neck, I have it back on my traps. Set up, good base, shoulder width apart, slight bend in the knees, push the hips back, stretch it there through the hamstrings, chest is parallel to the ground, and I'm squeezing the glutes and the hips on the way up. Again, reaching back with the hips, hinge back, chest up, parallel to the ground. I'm coming back up, squeeze the glutes, and push through with the hips. In, like I was gonna do a butterfly stretch. Arms out to the side for balance, hips up in the air, and I'm pushing the hips up through the sky. When I finish that, I'm coming down, feet are still together, arms are going behind the shoulder blades, crunch up, one, two, bring it back down. Crunch up, One, two, bring it back down. Getting that 2 second pause at the top. Then I'm going to a full sit up, feet together, all the way up in the full sit up.